relaxing evening tonight, and I'll tell you about my Memorial Day weekend 2021. Sick to my stomach. You know those little lizards? They're like the body is maybe 4, 5, or 6 inches long. They're small, and then there's the tail. I noticed we have a ton of them. Just everybody has them outside. Neighbors have them. And I'm scared of bugs and spiders, and all those things are really scare me and get to me. For as much as a tomboy as I was back in the day, I couldn't handle bugs and spiders, little creepy crawler animals back then, and I can't handle them today. Although I did enjoy the creepy crawler toy. Do you remember that creepy crawler toy from the 60s where the kids, you'd put the goop in this little metal mold and you'd bake it? I think it was called Creepy Crawlers. Anyways, I'll have to see if I can find out. So, I'm at the edge of my bed, terrified to move. I don't want to get near the lizard, but more so, I don't want the lizard running away so that I'll never catch it, so that it's loose in the bedroom somewhere. That'll really throw me in a tailspin. I'm sitting with my feet on the floor at the edge of my bed. And he's on the carpet, oh, 3 or 4 feet in front of me. And I'm thinking, if I could just stand up and throw something heavy on top of him, it will disable him. I could get a towel, pick him up, and get rid of him, right? Yeah. Only half right. I took my handy dandy heaviest iPad. It's the one, I think it was the 2011 version or the 2014 version. Those iPads weigh a ton. And threw it, like, kind of stood up. And I got over him and threw it down hard. But he was still moving, but not at a rapid pace. And by this time, I had eyeballed my grabber. You know those grabber things? You may have seen it purchased a year or two ago. If you can't reach something up on a shelf, it's this like 3 foot grabber or the handle, and you go and get it. And those things pick up things off the floor. They're wonderful. And they have like a suction cup at the end. I just got a good grabber. I'm convinced I'm gonna be able to get him with my grabber. Didn't happen. I tried 3 different times and I was following it. He was like hobbling and he ended up going under a pile of boxes in a corner. I was sick. I couldn't sleep for like 3 hours. And I called my daughter. I feel really bad now, but I was so frazzled, and I knew not to even say a word about it to my husband because, you know, there's nothing he can do really, and he probably just would have poo-pooed it. When I realize that he can't understand my fear, it makes me more nervous. Anyways, so bless her heart, I call her, and she was all set. She had everything ready for her 3-day Memorial Day weekend. She's going up north. Tell their situation. I said, I need help. I know you're heading out early, but can you stop over at such and such center, pick up some lizard traps, whatever they have for indoor traps, not a spooky spray, toxic, because it's indoors. So she came back with, where is it now? I just had it here. Oh. Okay. She comes back with 4 of these. And there's 4 of these little black sticky things. And she said, Mom, they had nothing special for lizards, but this Tomcat glue trap for a mouse size. I said it was excellent. And I was real happy with it. And I was able to, I opened up 3 times 4. I had 4 little squares all around the front and kind of the side of this little molehill area where I thought that lizards would try to escape. And also I just felt comfortable about that. And then I thought, no, I'm probably not gonna catch him Friday day, because he's not going to come out in the light. He's probably going to come out in the dark. But either way, whenever he comes out, I'm going to catch him. So the bad part, I wasn't even the worst part. The worst part was thinking, you know, where did this lizard come from? How did it get into the house? And I had two ideas that I've always been nervous about. I feared my worst nightmare had come true with lizards. Because they crawl up walls. They can go everywhere and anywhere. I like Spider-Man. And we have a kitchen window. During the day, I slide the window to get fresh air in the house. And though it does have a good screen, it has wiggle room that if a lizard really wanted to get in, they could. Always worries me for decades. It's never happened. I've never seen it. So I don't let it go. But the other more than likely scenario is it came in through the front door. I have a bad habit of when I go out to do anything out in the front, check the mail, water a plant, go to my car, I do not shut the front door all the way, and I really need to do that. Not that there's lizards on the patio, but they're just everywhere. They're kind of like running all around. If they see you coming, they'll hide behind a little pot. And I have seen them dart across the porch. When you startle them, you open the door and you come out of the porch, they run across. So, I'm 99 and 100% purely sure that's where the lizard came in. Okay, so. Then that started to become the more upsetting part than the actual lizard in the house was I need to really make sure I know where it came in from and that it never happens again. Okay, so Friday comes and few times I seen him kind of peeking his head out, and you guys, this is really spooky. I've never seen a lizard in, you know, standing mode. Every time I've seen a lizard, they're darting here or darting there. The way they look around, you know the Geico commercial, that animated Geico lizard? The way his head tilts, I'm telling you, I was watching this lizard as it's kind of peeking its head out, and that's exactly what it was doing. Oh my goodness. It really freaked me out. Like, you could see him turning his head, really calculating. Oh, it just scared me. But I did learn something, that they really do look like a Geico animated thing on TV. So a few hours of that, and I had my grabber stick, and I'd get the grabber stick close to the little hole where he was. I'd try to get him thinking he can't see, but every time it got close, he went back in. Okay. A few hours later, I look, and there he is looking out, but this time his front hand or paw or claw is out, and a few of his bony little fingers are on this, like right there, like just barely on there. So I'm thinking he's testing out the waters and he's not really stuck. But he was stuck. These three or four little fingers that had just were barely on there at all had him stuck so good. And I didn't know it until I saw him in that position. I had my grabber. And he kind of jumped and he couldn't get away. I was so happy. I got him with my grabber. I pulled him out of a little hole area. and then kind of dropped them on the other sticky traps to where he was definitely stuck. And so I put that together and set it outside, and I don't know what happened to him after that, if he wiggled his way out, but he was pretty messed up by my grabber. So needless to say, it was a real rough start to my Memorial Day weekend. And I have some other traps for backup in case I ever need it again, but I don't think so. I'm very careful, cautious now about the front door and the kitchen window. So, but on a good note, that night I got to watch that movie, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, with Leonardo DiCaprio and Brad Pitt. Loved it. Oh, it's my new favorite movie now. I'm just about tempted to watch it a second time now. I liked it that much. And I'm gonna wait for another video and tell you more about the story. It will be a definite spoiler alert. That movie is such a part of my life. It seemed like every part of the movie was like my life growing up here in Southern California, but I'll tell you more about that later. Other than that, we watched the Indianapolis 500 race. That was exciting. We had a nice Memorial Day meal. We had barbecue tri-tip, macaroni salad, garlic bread, and all the trimmings and fixings. Reminder, if you enjoyed this video, to please push the thumbs up like button. Really appreciate your help with that. And as always, thanks.